Hey guys, how you doing today? My name is Yash and I started my e-commerce business about 3 years ago. So 3 years ago, the only thing I had was school, a girlfriend, and a budget of $3,000. I wanted to start something different and stop doing the same job that I was doing every day. I was a full-time student. I went to school every morning, came back, and I devoted some time at my full-time job. I was working almost 7 days a week, either at school or at work, and was hardly actually making my ends meet and going back to daddy for money. So what happened? The whole story, fast forward 3 years today, I have my own office and we are right now in my warehouse and we're talking to you and I'm trying to educate you about something that I did. So being very straightforward, I would like to tell you that if you have a dream in your head, first of all, you should go all in. You should go and try to at least make it happen. The worst case scenario, it will not work out. The best case scenario, it would work out. The simple thing is, if we are not going to try, we're sure to fail because we're not trying on an aspect, I'm 100% sure we won't be successful. So the same way I'm telling you guys, so in order to do different things or in order to prove and provide for yourself and for your family and to meet your goals, start today. If you stumbled upon this video because you were searching or if you've subscribed to the channel and you just came across because I'm doing this video, just to let you know, this video is going to contain much more business related insight. I actually have more information about how to start an e-commerce business, how to go on and fund your e-commerce business, and what is the best platform to actually have your e-commerce business on, how much time you would have to dedicate to your e-commerce business, is dropshipping better or having a product better, or what kind of setup you should have in your e-commerce store, and all that cool stuff. So if this is not the content you're looking for, this is not the right video, and go ahead and skip ahead. And you could probably go watch my other videos. I do vlogs and I do different things I do in my daily life. And all my vlogs kind of go around motivation and work. So go ahead and check those out also. And if you're sticking around because you're really, really into the mood of doing something new, something different, and you want to just perform and you want to be awesome, so let's go ahead and discuss this right away. In today's video, we're discussing mainly about what is an e-commerce business. So, being very simple and straightforward, e-commerce business is selling and buying over the internet. So now that we are in 2017, or I don't know when you're watching this video, we are in a new generation, a new age. We're buying and most sales are happening online. Amazon is kicking ass and even Walmart's not able to catch up with Amazon because it's all online. So what online does is it gives you the exposure. So say 50 years before the internet, what you wanted to do if you wanted to sell a product, and say I had a great beautiful product and I only knew people who could afford $50 worth of product and I had $100 worth of product, it would have been very difficult for me to reach them. But in today's generation, you could easily reach with a $100 product to the whole niche or the whole class of people who can afford a $100 product because you could target market through the internet or through social media or through Google and stuff. So putting that out, it is very easy in today's world to actually make it happen. That being said, is e-commerce an easy way out? Like, it's just like create something and then just get thousands of sales, or is it something that's gonna pay your bills every day, or what is it? So for that, the answer is it depends. It totally depends on what you plan to do. Do you plan to keep your e-commerce store significantly big, huge, or what are your plans with the store? So I have developed stores initially when I started my business. I started a Shopify store. Obviously, in this video, we'll be talking more about Shopify because that's my expertise. So I created a Shopify store. And as I was struggling, I went around and told people about how cool e-commerce was. So I wanted people to hop on. And when they hop on to e-commerce, they come looking for me and ask me to build their e-commerce stores. So I kept on building their Shopify stores, and I built over 17 stores within like about the period of 10 to 12 months, about a year. The first year when we were doing just all right. When I was doing that, a lot of people had a lot of ideas with their products and a lot of ideas about their stores. few people wanted to have all different kind of products listed together in one domain name or one store. They were trying to replicate Amazon, they were trying to replicate eBay. So out of, say, 17 stores, 10 of them were like, they were trying to just get AliExpress and Alibaba stuff and just ship them through them, like drop ship it through Alibaba and AliExpress, and they've never even felt and touched and have the feel for the product. Creating the store was a little time consuming, getting the products right, and they got the Oberlo app, or that time it was called the AliExpress something app, so AliCopy, something like that it was called. So people use that app, and it's a great app. It copies all images, it copies all the data, all the descriptions, the sizing, the pricing, and everything. So that's a beautiful thing. But I kept on thinking in my head that, am I doing it wrong? Because what I was doing was to start a product, and I just came in with a different kind of product, a product that never existed in the market, or I never saw that product, and I didn't know if people would be interested in that product, and I had no ideas. So when I started, I just got that product made, and I started marketing on Facebook for $5 a day, and that seemed huge at that time. So that's another part of the story, but I started marketing it, and I started telling people what it was. So we kept going with it, and while I was doing it, I was comparing myself to all the other people who were doing like so many different kinds of products and doing it every day, different products, all kinds of products. They're doing dog leashes, they're doing dog chains, and then they're doing, on the other hand, they're doing rings and accessories, and they're doing all kinds of stuff. And they had like hundreds of things on their website. And they were planning to ship everything from Alibaba or AliExpress. And I'm not talking about one person, I'm talking about a community of people doing this, because what happened was it was getting really popular. So I kept on thinking I was really wrong. But today, 2 years down the line, I see only two of those 10 stores who were doing the drop shipping thing still exist. Other 8 have, like, they're gone. They don't exist online anymore. I totally understand one aspect out of it. The aspect is that you cannot just do, like, you cannot just plan to make it more like an eBay or Amazon store. Reason being, Amazon and eBay, what they particularly do, they are more like hubs where audiences go to look for the best price. So again, I'll say eBay and Amazon are more like product search engines where people go to find the best price. So what happens? People know what they're trying to look for. They exactly know what kind of product they're looking for. So say they're looking for a battery pack, they exactly know what kind of battery pack they're looking for and where it fits, and they will go and look and compare prices through different sellers and try to buy the correct one or try to buy the cheapest one. So the main intent for that buyer who goes to Amazon or eBay is to buy the cheapest product. So if you have ever gone to Prada website or a Chanel website or a Michael Kors website or a Louis Vuitton website, what you'll find there are thousands and thousands of iPhone cases available on eBay and Amazon, but people still buy from those web stores. So what is that about? Are those people, those who go to those websites, not smart enough? Or they don't know that there are products available on Amazon and eBay for cheaper prices? No. People know, like you and I, we both know Prada is going to be expensive, an Amazon product will be cheaper maybe, or an eBay product sold by a Chinese seller probably is cheaper. So what I totally mean in this is, when we make a store, we have to decide, are we trying to sell an array of products, or are we trying to build a brand? That is the key point. I went in the direction of creating a brand. I wanted to create a brand because selling product would make you money, and selling the brand would make you money one day if you get lucky. Like Tom's, they created a brand. Like Pura Vida bracelets, they created a brand. So all of these companies, they started small, but they created a brand because they did not want to do like 6-7 different things. The same way, like, I'm gonna go back and tell you, like, when I started my own store, I got so intrigued by this idea of doing too many things together in the same store that I went ahead and ordered some wooden sunglasses, some bracelets, and I tried to put them in my store. I'm thinking, oh, it's gonna work out. But what happened? I saw that as I market, I keep on selling the same product that I really wanted to sell, but these bracelets and all of them, they kept on coming back because they were not great quality, or they were not awesome and awesome to feel, or they did not have the value. I was not adding any value by bringing those bracelets and those sunglasses. So I realized, in order to prosper in an e-commerce kind of system, you have to actually make products which are relevant to a niche. So first step, if you want to create an e-commerce store, I would suggest the first thing to do is to find a product or a category. By one whole category. So say you want to get into clothing, decide you want to go into men clothing or women clothing. Say you are drop shipping men and women clothing, you could do that now because you have Printful and then you have Teespring and all these companies who could print your t-shirt on demand. That's perfect. So let's skip this example. Let's not use a t-shirt company example. Let's say we are doing some other product. Let's say we're doing shoes. So you have to first decide, because it's going to be very expensive to do too many things at the same time. And when I'm talking about this point, I'm not talking about all those people, those who have a lot of money to back their projects up. So I'm talking about people who were like me when they were starting their businesses. It was either part-time or they were trying to start it from the scratch and they did not have too much funding around. So when I started, I just kept to women products. So if you're, say, you're starting shoes, either decide you want to start men's shoes or women's shoes. And once you've decided, think about 10 to 12 different designs that you're going to work around. Don't go crazy and try to get 35 different products and try to market each and every out of the 35 product, because it's going to be expensive. I simply mean this. Say you have a bowl of candies. Say you have Kit Kats in there, you have Twix in there, and you have Snickers in there. So now you show that bowl to somebody, they would say, oh, he has a bowl of candies, correct? So the first thing they said was that you have a bowl of candies. They would not say he has a bowl of Twix, Snickers, and Kit Kat, right? They won't say that. They would say that he has a bowl of candies, because they're different candies and they just generalize the whole product. Now, whereas if you go and spend and you go buy all Snickers, you take it to somebody and they say, oh, he has a bowl of Snickers. So what it did, it actually specified, or not generalized the bowl anymore, it specified the bowl. It said the bowl only contains Snickers. So what that means, you've branded your bowl. Your bowl is now Snickers. It's not candy, it's Snickers. So this is how it works. So if we're going to be marketing women shoes, we will be telling people, oh, we do women shoes. So XYZ company is equal to women shoes. So they're not going to say, oh, they are another shoe company, or they're something like Nike. They are women shoes. So when you do that, this is a good way of branding your e-commerce store. We're going to stop this video right here, guys. This is more about e-commerce. So I already discussed with you about this branding part. In the next second video, we will be talking more about how much to budget and how to get product and how to get prototypes made. And in the forthcoming videos, we will have some computer time, and we will be talking about screens and how we talk about Shopify and everything. Some cool stuff coming that way. So I appreciate your time, guys. And if you like the video, hit the subscribe button right here. Yeah, I'm looking at you. So hit the subscribe button, please. And once you're done hitting the subscribe button, like the video if you like the video. I really would appreciate your interaction with the video. Go underneath in the comment section and please let me know what is your idea and where you want to be helped at, so I could do that video as quick as possible, because I've had some experience in this. So if you have any other questions about business and about the business structure you should have before, any other questions you have, you could leave it in the comment section down there, and I read each and every comment, obviously. So, and you could check out my last video right here. So last video here, subscribe here. Thank you, guys. Have a good day.